Hello, it's Susan here, and just wanted to thank everyone who prompted me to do a video on this one that I did yesterday. A little bit of color shift in some of these, which I just love. Look at that, amazing. So this is a 12 by 12 canvas. So I didn't want to do another canvas, obviously. I have two in my house of the same painting. So I'm going to use these flexible canvases from the DIY Mandala Stone company. She calls them bean canvas. And the great thing about these is you can paint them, and then when you're all done, you peel it off and you can stick it anywhere you like. So if you have a wall or an apartment where you're not allowed to put nails in the wall, or just some spaces that you just, you know, you want temporary art that you can change up, and they're restickable. So if you take it off, you can put it back on this backing if you keep it and hang on to it for a while. Also for gifts, if you want to mail it, it's not going to cost as much as a canvas. So there's lots of benefits to these. And I believe they're on her website. I don't think they're on Etsy, but I'll put links, of course, like I always do, in the description of the video. So here we are. Here's another example of one, just a little smaller one. And just paint away. I usually have some that are already prepped and ready to go, so it's kind of nice to grab and go. So here I have prepped my little canvas with the black gesso, which, you know, if you've watched my videos, this is all I use for my prep. What I like about it is it's just one coat and it covers it beautifully. And it adds good grip to the paints so the paint doesn't slide off. I've used the Happy Dotting Company flexible stencil here. And this is their 8x8, and each of those spaces, I believe it's a half inch. Yeah, they're half inch apart. I only do that on here just so that you can get a guide on to where my placement is, but I'm not a big fan of using stencils, mainly because I always am checking my distance when I'm dotting. Sometimes it goes off. I don't rely on my stencils 100%. But anyway, here I have marked it. excuse me. I've used, I like chalk pencils. That's just my go-to. I have tried other things, but I just keep going back to this. This is by Marco. And if anybody has had experience with AliExpress, you can buy quite a few of these very inexpensively. Sometimes there may be fine hairline cracks inside the chalk here where you just have to sharpen a little bit more. But at the price of these, it's not a big deal. And so the other thing I like to do once I've marked my surface is I give it a little bit of a rub to take off some of the chalk. And the reason why is sort of anything that I have on my canvas, sometimes the paint will retract around the lines and then you get an odd shaped dot. So I found that if I just remove off the excess, I don't have that problem anymore. excuse me, I will attach a photo of the paints that I've used, but I've used a mixture of readily available for most places, Canada, US. I'm not sure about other countries, but I'm sure you can find matching type of colors. These are folk art. So those are both folk art. One's the Color Shift Violet Flash, which in this you can really see the color shift on these. Love it, love it, love it, love it. I've used a white. This is all pearl. All of these are metallic pearls. The teal topaz is just a beautiful color. I love this one. I've used a nickel, one Arteza, only because I couldn't find a color in my other collection that was quite as soft as this one. I tried to have a very soft, misty look to the whole mandala. We've had a lot of fog here recently, and it's just so soft and gentle. We've also had some blossoms come out on some of the trees, so I thought, well, I'll bring in a little bit of pink for the blossoms. And it's a very soft pink, this one here, pink blush. Very, very pretty and very muted. All these colors are very muted, but they all have a bit of depth at the same time. Okay, so there, I think I covered off. Oh, yes. And so this is made by DIY, and so are all the tools that I use. And if you watch my videos, you know that I use these for all of my dotting. Occasionally I'll use the dotting center ones, but these are my go-to. And all you need is a collection of dotting styluses, starting from the range of about a 0.5 up to probably 2.5. Nothing fancy, just a variety of sizes. I also use this very pointy one. It's a 0.5. I think it's probably less than 0.5, to be honest. I have some new tools, but I'm waiting for my calibrator so that I know exactly what size they are. The other fun little tool that I have is this one, and I use that for mixing my paints. And I got this in a cute little set of three tools. So this has got a little scooper, and that's a point. So you could probably use that also for dragging your swooshes. And then that one, excellent for mixing, easy to clean. These I got off of AliExpress for like under $3, I think. The US is probably even cheaper than that. Anyway, the other thing you'll probably need is, if you need to thin your paints, is a pouring medium, or I use a diluted down flow aid. It's a ratio 1:20. I always have those handy because as the paint sits, it can get a little bit stringy. And that's about it. So let's get going. Here we go. First dot is 27 in the teal topaz. Throughout the video, on these larger dots, you will see me applying paint, you know, two or three, sometimes four times. And this, when I'm adding the paint on here, I'm not really pushing down. I'm just sort of putting another layer very gently. And the reason I do this is the dot will dry slightly domed. I'm just sort of tapping this so if there's any air bubbles, and to flatten it down a little bit. So yeah, just adding lots of paint. And I really like the effect. All right, time for our first little dots. I'm placing these directly on the grid line, excuse me, and adjust the size so that they all match there. What I found with this particular stencil is that when I was putting the lines on, some of them weren't quite perfect. So when my eye was looking at this line was a little bit to the left, so I place my dot a little bit to the right, as you can see here, because it wasn't equal between the other two dots. And that's just because when you place your chalk lines down, it could have been, you know, hugging one side of that groove opposed to the other and not being in the middle. So this is why I don't always fully rely on my grid line. I kind of gauge it more so with my eyes. Hope that makes sense.
So now that they're all equally spaced, I will go in and fill in. And this is, I found, the best way to get things nice and symmetrical. When I first learned, I learned via Otana patterns, Ginger. All her patterns were done without grid lines, if I can recall. And so I learned just to trust my own spacing, and in that way things will always be symmetrical. It's a good practice to just go without using grid lines sometimes, but obviously, yeah, just do what works best for you. And there we go, all done. For this step, we're just going to do the 8 dots, so transitioning from 16 to 8. Here's an example that I'm showing, the spacing of that grid line that's supposed to go between these two is a little wonky. So I'm just going to go with my eye opposed to the grid line. I muted myself, so that's why you see all the hand gestures there. So just between your dots there. Some paints I find can be a little stringy, so when you pull up your dotting tool, you might get a little tail. So the trick to that is just to always lift slowly up, straight up opposed to up and to the side. And you'll also see me like that swirl it, and that's just to disconnect the little tail that's hanging there. The color shift paints are notorious for that, very, very stringy, but beautiful colors, so it's worth just taking a little extra time and being patient with it, because it's so rewarding to see the color of the paint. Okay, so just ignore the purple color you see here. I dipped in the wrong one and didn't realize it right away. So you want to use teal topaz here. Later in the video, I did correct this, but I waited until these dots were dry. It's sometimes easier just to dot over top of a dry dot than to try and remove these because they were quite nestled in that space. It would be a little bit messy for me to try and get them out. So, teal topaz. I found that teal color is much worked better for me visually than this purple. But you can always customize all your mandalas from tutorials by picking different colors or making adjustments to colors as you go. Anyway, that's why you see the purple. Throughout the video, when I'm doing these tapers, sometimes I will dip and dot, like this one. I did three dip and dot and then taper. And that is something that you can judge for yourself when you're doing your own dotting. We all pick up different amounts of paint on our styluses, and you'll kind of know how far you can get before you totally run out of paint. When my hand leaves the screen, I'm dipping again. So this is three dots that I dip each time and then taper. So you'll do both sides for this. There you go. Further on in the video, I won't be showing the full process of every single dot or petal, I should say, doing the tapers. I'll condense it down to showing you the first couple. And figuring you should get it by now. That's further on in the video. All of this takes up so much memory. So for uploading the video, if I can just condense it down to showing you the first couple, then it makes it easier for me to upload the completed video for you. Hope that is going to work okay for you guys. You know, just to pause and then catch up and then play again. But that'll be a little further on here. So this paint I had just mixed up, and I added just a little bit too much pouring medium. So those two little dots there are touching, and you know, that's fine in the big scheme of things. You probably would never see it, but I will go. The type of person I am, I'll go in and fix it later. So yeah, paint consistency can really change the way and the size your dots will look. So that's always something to be mindful of when you're watching the videos. This is a 1 mL or 1 mm, sorry, stylus with a really runny paint. So it might look different with a different texture of paint. right, we're making chubby swooshes. I'm not sure if you've seen any of my previous videos, but they're, I like to put a second coat on my large metallic swooshes just to makes them a little chubbier and makes the, mica in the paint sort of all lay in the same direction. And so here I did a little boo-boo. I'm just going to take this one off and redo it. But yeah, I can't remember which video it was where I did a close-up where you could see how I do it. Sort of very gently dropping a bit more paint along the swoosh. So that's what I'm doing when you see me go over that a couple of times. Look how easy that comes off. And we'll let that dry and we'll go on to the next spot.
Okay, did all the little pearls. They look really pretty. So now that I'm at this point, I can kind of make a guess that it's gonna have to make some adjustments in size for the canvas. On this one, let me just get my little pointer. This is where we're at in here. So I'm looking at the distance from this dot out. So I believe this was an 8. Just guessing by the look of it. I think it was probably an 8. Where are we here? Oh, no, it's a 10. 10, 10, 10. Yep, that's a 10. So that's probably a 12, and that's a 14, then 16. So if that's a 10, I think I'm going to bring it down to an 8, just down two sizes in here. If you're doing this size of canvas, then you would want to do 10, 12, 14, 16 to get that size of a petal. But I'm taking it down just so that I can fit it on here. I can, you know, also change the length of this little swoosh in here to save myself a bit of space there, because that's a good inch right in there. So we'll see what happens here. There we go. We're getting there. So the next round of tapers will be the white ones.
Well, if you still have your audio on and you can hear this, what I'm doing here is two dots, so two the same size, and the last one is like a taper, so it's a little smaller. Okay, just adding a few little details on before I am finished here. This just adds a little bit of twinkle, which I really like. And so I just wanted to thank you again for watching and supporting my channel by hitting subscribe and liking my videos. Please comment below if there's anything you'd like me to do for you. If you have questions, I try to answer them as quickly as I can. And there you go. Well, thanks again, and have a great new year. Okay, there we go. All done. So that wasn't too bad for modifying a 12-inch canvas to fit into a 10-inch canvas. I'm pretty happy with the way that turned out. So depending on what size your surface is, you know, just adjusting some of your sizes, smaller or bigger, in progression will make it fit on whatever canvas you like. And again, oops, so sorry, my desk is a mess right now. You should see it. Not, you don't want to see it. So I'd say that's, stop wiggling. Pretty close. What do you think? Pretty close. Pretty close. Anyway, I hope you enjoy the video. I did have to speed things up a little bit as far as turning off the recording with all these tapers. Otherwise, the video will be way too long and difficult for me to upload. So, there you have it. Thanks again. Oh, that was Jasper. Jasper says, thanks for watching.